Preparation of the heart. We are preparing ourselves to begin the most significant and joyful liturgical season. We are starting Advent, and we are preparing for Christmas, for the birth of Jesus. For us, as pilgrims of love, the baby Jesus is our patron, our guide. Through his divine infancy, he has enlightened our mission for 20 years, and I have entered into this experience of God and my returning into the faith, into the Catholic Church, after being falling away for 33 years, through a novena of the divine infancy, which is a very old Catholic tradition in Colombia. I recommend you to join us starting on the 16th of December through the 24th to pray the Divine Infant's Christmas Novena. We are going to publish every day's Novena in our YouTube channel. So you can enter it through my name to YouTube and you will find the Novena every day. I have had, through the years, a very close relationship with the divine infancy of Jesus. I have found that the divine infancy of Jesus is the nest of the church, and we all know that in the manger of Bethlehem, we receive this baby in the hands of Joseph and Mary, by the will of the Father, as the greatest gift for humanity. Our Redeemer was born in Bethlehem and is born in our hearts through the liturgy every year while we are in exile on this earthly life. The Church is divine in its liturgy, and it teaches us to prepare ourselves for the afterlife, the life in the spirit. So it is very important to understand divine infancy and to understand how the Church leads us from the manger of Bethlehem into the cross, and how this is the path, the way that has been drawn by the Messiah so that we can reach this climbing of the Mount of Zion into the Holy Land, into the city of Jerusalem, the city, the Jerusalem of heaven. And this is our journey. That's why Christmas becomes the most transcendental encounter of our faith, because it is the birth of the Messiah. And though we are, in a way, following sacred tradition and sacred history, still, when we enter spiritually into this realm of the mystical life of the Church, we understand that in the eternal present of God, Jesus is born actually in our celebration of Christmas, because that baby Jesus' birth is in the eternal presence of God forever. So when we mystically enter this realm, we are celebrating the actual birth of Jesus as if it is happening right there when we celebrate it. So that's why if we give it the spirituality that it demands, from Advent into Christmas, we will experience a personal encounter with Jesus in his divine infancy. Divine infancy is about littleness, about nothingness. It's about the King of creation being born in a manger, laying his body on hay, the most fragile element of nature, hay. And he's teaching us that this is not our home, that we are pilgrims, we are in transit, And he's inviting us to follow the spirituality of the cross, which is understanding that this earthly life is the first step into an eternal life, and that we will be molded by the hands of the Creator in order for us to enter to the fullness of the spiritual life, to the glory of God, after being molded in this earthly life through our trials and toils and tribulations and sufferings, because we have to learn our path of love by learning to love. And by nature, because of original sin, we tend to everything that is not love. We tend to go away from God, who is love. And it's a big teaching, because we have to teach ourselves to obey the law of God in order to walk with God and to be with God forever in His glory. All of this has to be done in a very extraordinary way. We need to realize that this particular liturgical season is giving us the opportunity to become more and more spiritual, to go into the depth of the mystic of our faith. You understand that as Catholics, we have been given everything is needed for us to go deeper and deeper into the mystery of the Messiah through the sacraments. When we go to confession, we have the greatest opportunity to die to self, because we dare to confess to another sinner who is the priest. And regardless of the state of the priest with God, he has the anointing of the church to forgive our sins and to break all the chains and attachments we have to the material world and to the spirits of the world, to the fallen spirits, which is sin itself. And then we are prepared to enter into the greatest power of all, the greatest gift, which is the Eucharist. If we understand this bread of life, the strength that it brings to our life, then we know that we can really become that spiritual through the Eucharist, and we learn how to be mystical, how to overcome all these attachments to the flesh that lead us and tends us to sin. And then we let ourselves be lifted by our higher self, by the Spirit, into the realm of God, into the glory of God, into the graces that Jesus has brought to us through His incarnation, and the reason why He came to redeem us, to free us, to pay with His blood for our freedom from sin, from the devil. So this is an extraordinary season. Advent is the season of waiting. We are waiting for the birth of Jesus, a preparation, a beautiful waiting. It's waiting for the grace, waiting for the greatest gift, waiting for the birth of the Messiah. It's an amazing preparation if we take it spiritually. If we take it just religiously, we are just going through another Christmas, another Advent, and it's not going to make any difference. We will probably go to church with a little more piety, but that will not spiritualize our lives, our religion. So it is important for us to understand that the church, through the liturgy, is divine, which means if we understand liturgy, we understand divinity, and therefore we enter into the divinity of the church. And that is what God wants us to achieve during this earthly life, so that when He calls us, we will be standing already within the divine realm. So that means we will be standing in the glory of God. So may the Lord bless this Advent to all of you and prepare your hearts for Christmas, so that when the divine infant Jesus is born, your heart could be in fire, burning with the love of God, and bringing all these gifts and love to your family, to your life, regardless of what is taking place in your life at this moment, because we are just pilgrims and everything is going to come to pass, regardless of what it is. We are going towards and walking towards the greatest gift of all, the city of Jerusalem, the Jerusalem of heaven. So let's climb the Mount of Zion together and praise the Lord for this Christmas that He's given us. Amen.